Hi, my name is Vipul Goyal. I'll be talking about non-malleable secret sharing for general access structures. This is a joint work with Ashutosh Kumar. So secret sharing is a very fundamental primitive in cryptography. If you are a cryptographer, then the chances are you have used secret sharing in designing your systems in some form or the other. Just a brief reminder, we have two algorithms, share and reconstruct. The share algorithm takes a message, which is the secret, and splits it into n parts or n shares, n strings, sh1 to shn. The reconstruction algorithm takes some subset of these strings, what is called as an authorized set, for example, any t out of these n strings, and then it's supposed to recover the original secret, the message back. And there are two key properties to be satisfied. First is, of course, correctness, which says the following, that any authorized set of shares can be used to reconstruct the correct secret. The message that we end up with should be the message that we started with. And then we have the property of secrecy, which says that any unauthorized subset of shares, if your subset is, you know, not big enough, then it should have no information at all about the underlying secret. So typically in secret sharing, we are concerned with the secrecy, you know, hiding this message M. But what if the goal of the adversary is to tamper with this message instead, right? So we can consider the following kind of experiment where the adversary takes all these shares, applies some kind of tampering function to these shares to output tampered shares, SH1 tilde up to SHN tilde. Tilde denotes the tampered version of the variable. And then the reconstruction algorithm takes some subset and outputs a tampered secret M tilde. So in this setting, one could ask for several different guarantees. And accordingly, in literature, people have proposed several different notions, examples being verifiable secret sharing, the notion of error detecting codes and AMD codes is also very close to this setting. And each of these primitives, it comes with different guarantees and has different applications. So one such primitive was proposed very recently in a work of Goyal and Kumar, and it's called non-malleable secret sharing. So here, in a sense, the guarantee that we want is that any kind of tampering, any kind of non-trivial tampering by the adversary essentially destroys the secret. In more detail, either the distribution of the tampered secret is independent of the secret that we started with, which means that the original secret has been destroyed, or the secret remains unchanged, which refers to the case when, for example, the adversary did not tamper with anything at all. So any tampering, the secret is gone, and some unrelated string shows up. So a little more formally, in non-malleable secret sharing, we can consider two experiments. In the first experiment, the original secret can be M1, which is divided into various shares. The shares are somehow tampered by the adversary. And after reconstruction, we get this message, M tilde. We can consider a second experiment in which we instead start with a different message. Let's call this message M2. And again, the tampering happens, and you get M tilde prime. And we require that the distribution of M tilde and M tilde prime should be pretty similar, statistically close, perfectly close, or whatever you have it. So essentially, what this means is that regardless of whether you started with M1 or M2, you ended up with the same tampered message, which means that the tampered message is actually independent of the message which you started with. So now, let me talk a little bit about how this tampering is being done. One could consider various tampering models. The most natural and probably the simplest of all is what can be seen as the individual tampering model. So here, the adversary tampers with each of these shares individually. In more detail, adversary can be represented by n functions, f1 to fn, where the function fi takes the share I as input and outputs a tampered version of this share I. So n functions, they are acting independently on the n shares. And finally, we have the tampered secret. A natural strengthening of this model is what can be seen as joint tampering. So here, the adversary partitions the n shares into, let's say, two disjoint subsets, A and B. The adversary takes all the shares in A, tampers with them jointly, and produces some subset of tampered shares. And similar is the case with the secret B. And notice that we cannot have a single tampering function which takes all of these shares as input. And the reason being that if the tampering function gets all the shares as input, then it can just reconstruct, recover the original message, and then replace the original shares with shares of a message which, let's say, is just m plus 1 or something related. So in that case, clearly, non-malleability is something which we cannot achieve. Going beyond even this joint tampering model, we can consider what can be seen as the overlapping joint tampering, for lack of a better name. So in this case, the two sets in which we partition the shares can be possibly overlapping. The only restrictions is that shares in any set must not be sufficient for reconstruction. Otherwise, the same kind of attack I was talking about applies. As an example, we could have a function f, which could take the first n minus 1 shares and outputs the first half of the tampered shares. And similarly, we have a function g, which takes 2 to n of these strings and then outputs the second half of these strings. So before moving on to our results and the construction so on, there's this very beautiful line of work on non-malleable codes, which is very related to our notion. In particular, we have non-malleable codes in the so-called split state model, where the guarantee is as follows. The message can be encoded into two states, L and R, left state and right state. The adversary tampers with each of these states individually. And then finally, we have the tampered message M tilde. And very roughly, non-malleable codes require that the distribution of M tilde should be independent of the distribution of M, right? So this guarantee seems something very similar to what we are hoping for. But the key difference between non-malleable codes in the split state model and non-malleable secret sharing is the property of secrecy. Non-malleable codes do not explicitly require any secrecy of the message. In particular, like one of the states could leak the message entirely. Nonetheless, it's possible to show that two split state non-malleable codes are also two out of two non-malleable secret sharing. But such an implication does not hold when the number of states grow beyond two. In particular, a three split state non-malleable code need not be a three out of three non-malleable secret sharing. It's very easy to construct examples of three split state non-malleable codes, which are not three out of three non-malleable secret sharing. As an example, you can divide your message into two parts using any two out of two split state non-malleable code. And in the third part, or the third state, you can just put the message entirely in clear. So one can show that this would still be a valid three split state non-malleable code, but clearly it cannot be a three out of three non-malleable secret sharing. It has no secrecy whatsoever. The third state reveals the message entirely. But nonetheless, I should say that our notion is directly inspired by these works on non-malleable codes. So constructing non-malleable codes in the split state model actually proved to be surprisingly hard. There have been a number of works in the literature. First, a construction was proposed in the computational setting, assuming a trusted setup. Then an unconditional construction was proposed for a single bit message, which was then generalized to arbitrary length message. And since then, a number of works have studied like stronger properties, the rate of these codes, and so on. And non-malleable codes have also found interesting applications and connections to other areas in cryptography, tamper-resilient cryptography, designing non-malleable commitments, and so on. And many of these applications, or in fact, I should say, most of these applications use non-malleable codes as 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing. So another application of non-malleable secret sharing was given in this work of Goel and Kumar. They introduced the notion of non-malleable message transmission. This is a problem which is inspired by the problem of perfectly secure message transmission. Again, there have been a number of works in this direction. So in this setting, we have a sender trying to send a message to the receiver, and all the nodes on the path are corrupted. In particular, for example, these nodes are trying to change the message. If the message says attack, they want to change it to defend, and vice versa, right? And here, our goal will be to ensure the non-malleability property. Either the adversaries don't modify the message at all, or the original message is essentially lost. So here, one can see that you can directly use non-malleable secret sharing schemes. You can divide the message into 4 parts here using a scheme which is secure against individual tamperings. And if the adversary is modified, then the message is essentially destroyed. A stronger setting is when these adversaries may also be connected to each other. In that case, they might pool their shares before tampering with the shares. So in this case, we might end up having to use non-malleable secret sharing with joint tampering, and so on. So various tampering models you can consider. So the main result in this work, prior work, was a construction of a T out of N non-malleable secret sharing scheme. The construction was in the joint tampering model. And the adversary could partition the set of shares into any 2 disjoint and unequal sets. And prior to this work, T out of N non-malleable secret sharing schemes were, of course, unknown, even in the individual tampering model. The only thing that was known, of course, is just 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing. So a natural question is, what about more general access structures beyond threshold? So we continue this line of work, and we have 2 main results in this paper. The first result is a general compiler, which takes any statistical or computational secret sharing scheme realizing some access structure A. We can construct a non-malleable secret sharing scheme for the same access structure A. The security holds only in the individual tampering model. So we can instantiate this theorem based on various prior works by instantiating this result with a result of Kochumer and Vigderson. We get unconditional non-malleable secret sharing scheme for Boolean formulas, or even more generally for monotone span programs. Yao had this unpublished work in which he proposed secret sharing schemes for all of monotone P, instantiating our theorem based on this. We get computational non-malleable secret sharing for monotone P based on any one-way function. Even more recently, there's this work of Kumar Gotsky et al. They use techniques from multilinear maps and witness encryption to construct secret sharing for monotone NP. And again, we can apply our theorem and get non-malleable secret sharing for monotone NP. Right? Our second more theorem is, you know, going further in the tampering models and getting a result for overlapping joint tampering. So we construct an unconditional N out of N non-malleable secret sharing scheme with respect to overlapping joint tampering family. And of course, it's the first such non-malleable secret sharing scheme in such a model. Beyond this, just two out of two non-malleable secret sharing, all these 3 models are the same. So now, many of our construction ideas borrow from this paper of Goel and Kumar. So without explaining either their technique or our technique, I will try to explain to you the differences between the two. Let's see if I'm successful. So Goel and Kumar rely heavily on the following idea. It's an idea which is used multiple times in their paper. For generating shares of the message M under T out of N secret sharing. So first, even before getting the secret, before getting the message, they fixed T minus 1 shares, S1 to ST minus 1. And once the message is known, you can choose the last share S of T and all the rest of the shares S of T plus 1 to S of N accordingly. And this still gives you a valid T out of N secret sharing of the message M. So unfortunately, if we are talking about computational setting, this idea actually breaks down completely. This is because each share may have full information about the message M. So it's no longer possible to sample this share without knowing the message M. And this is because the share hides the message only computationally, but information theoretically, it may have full information about this message. So one thought which immediately comes to mind is, what if we choose the share SI as per some random message M prime, and then argue that anyway the share would look indistinguishable from the correctly chosen SI as per the right MI. So you can argue such indistinguishability, but unfortunately, indistinguishability is never sufficient for non-malleability, which is a much stronger property. So these kind of ideas don't work for us. So now let's try to construct, non-malleable secret sharing scheme for our setting. So first thing which I would like to remark, an idea which immediately does not work, is using any kind of linear secret sharing scheme. All the linear secret sharing schemes are malleable. You can multiply each share by 2, and you will get a share of twice the original message. And of course, these kind of ideas are beautifully exploited in designing secure multi-party computation and so on. But for us, it's all bad news. Instead, we will try to use 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing, which of course is known, and get non-malleable secret sharing for more advanced access structures. So let's try to do that. Here is the first attempt. You start with the original message, and you break it into 2 parts, L and R, using a 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing scheme. And then you further share both of these parts. L is shared into N shares, and so is R, using the scheme A share. So recall that you are given an underlying secret sharing scheme for an access structure A. So this is the sharing procedure which we are using. And let our share just be a concatenation of Li and Ri. So these are the shares which we'll get in our scheme. Now, remember that we are in the individual tampering setting. An adversary tampers with all of these shares individually, and we get L1 tilde, R1 tilde, and so on. And of course, you can reconstruct L tilde, R tilde, and get the tampered message. And our idea would be to prove the security of this scheme by relying on 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing. But remember that the security of 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing is guaranteed only if L and R are independently tampered. Here, the shares of L and shares of R are stored together. They can be jointly tampered. As such, it's not clear, how to argue that they are individually tampered. We really need to ensure that this R tilde is independent of L, depends only on R, and vice versa. L tilde must only depend on L and not on R. So how do we do that? We will just change this procedure slightly. Everything else remains the same, except now we secret share the message R using a 2 out of N secret sharing scheme. And for simplicity, assume that this is a T out of N secret sharing scheme where T is greater than or equal to 2. So any 2 shares are insufficient for reconstruction in A. This is a simplifying assumption I'll make for this talk. So it's important that the parameters of these 2 secret sharing schemes are different. For 1, 2 is enough for reconstruction, and for this, 2 is not enough for reconstruction. And now this, as we will see, this idea already gets us pretty far. And why is that? Now let's look at these tempered shears. One can argue that R tilde is fixed only given 2 of these tempered shears, because it's a 2 out of n secret sharing. Since we are in the individual tempering model, these 2 shares can only depend on 2 shares of L. But 2 shares of L have no information about L at all. So recall our condition was that L is, for example, a 3 out of n secret sharing scheme. So essentially, this means is what this means is that R tilde does not depend on L at all. So R tilde only depends on R. So this is an idea which originated in the literature on non-malleable commitment in a work starting with the work of Goel. And since then, you know, several subsequent works have used it. So this idea allows us to make some progress, but we are still not done. The reason being that L tilde can still depend on R. So we get like one-sided non-malleability. So to solve this problem, we will use a leakage resilient secret sharing. It's a notion that we study and we also construct in our paper. So in this notion, we have 2 secrets, let's say R and R prime. You share both of them using a 2 out of n leakage resilient secret sharing scheme. So adversary gets several shares of both R and R prime, enough shares potentially even to reconstruct R and R prime completely. And now adversary gets leakage on all the remaining shares of either R or R prime. And the guarantee is that the adversary cannot tell which share the leakage is coming from. Cannot distinguish is this leakage on R or R prime. This in particular also means that the leakage is actually independent of the message, either R or R prime, right? So this idea will allow us to get non-malleability from the other side. So here, the idea is to think of the tempered shares of L as leakage from the shares of R. So this would allow us to conclude that L tilde, the shares of L tilde and L tilde in turn, does not depend on R. And we have already concluded that R tilde is independent of L. So now we get non-malleability in both directions. We can conclude that L tilde is independent of R and R tilde is independent of L. And from this point onwards, we can hope to reduce the security to 2 out of 2 non-malleable secret sharing. So of course, this is just a high-level overview. There are several other techniques which go into making this work. In particular, we have to convert the given secret sharing, which is possibly computational, into a secret sharing with limited information theoretic secrecy, where any 2 shares hide the secret unconditionally. And it turns out that we have to run like 2 copies of a non-malleable secret sharing scheme in parallel to make this work. So quite a few open problems here. Can we go beyond T out of N for joint tampering, right? All our results here in this paper are for individual tampering. And for overlapping tampering, we gave a construction for N out of N non-malleable secret sharing scheme. Can we go beyond N out of N? And of course, there's always this question of can we improve the rate as well? And that's it.